from the glossary. I Ching. The original prima materia of the gene keys. The I Ching is a sacred Chinese text dating from about the 4th century BC. Many commentaries and versions of the I Ching exist, and it's perhaps best known as a popular oracle. The gene keys are a natural culmination of all previous incarnations of the I Ching. They ultimately point to the truth that all sacred texts have their source inside us. The same truths intuitively grasped by the ancient sages can now be proven by modern genetics. That the universe is built upon natural codes, and these codes can be deciphered and unlocked. The original I Ching was held in the highest esteem as a sacred text with the capacity to mirror living wisdom in every moment. Likewise, the gene keys point us inwardly to seek the source of our suffering and our shadows and guide us to transforming that suffering into creativity and freedom. I really like the simplicity of these terms. It doesn't make it complicated in any way. So, I Ching is an amazing work, and in some ways very, very ancient and dated, because it was written in the language of its time, and that makes it quite esoteric. And many, many versions exist, because there's an I Ching in every single one of us. So many people have felt called to explore their version of I Ching, whether it came from right inside them or whether it was there kind of penetrating into the original archaic text. What remains of the I Ching in, you know, every version is the formula itself. The formula is pure mathematics, you know, that's what it is. And it is the basis of life, of a code of life, of genetics. So amazing to come to this time in evolution where science actually discovers that code and then verifies what the ancient Chinese sages unlocked. So this, the truth that all sacred texts have their source inside us, that's the real key. Living in a holographic universe, everything is mirrored in everything else, as above, so below. So the I Ching is a symbol of that. It is a guidebook towards that. It shows us, it points us inwards, and that's what it was originally intended as. I believe it was intended as a spiritual, contemplative tool, in order that one could not just find out things, you know, because it became then obviously popularized as an oracle, or you could use it to help people make decisions and gain clarity on issues, which is absolutely a central part of its process. It was also used popularly as a divination tool, you know, to look at the future and say, well, that if I do this, what will happen? And also to tell the future popularly. And I think, you know, at that point it slightly lost its, you know, inner purpose in some way, because it's designed, like the gene keys, to keep pointing us back into the code that's inside us, and find through our own intuition, through our own inner voice, through our own inner revelation, the way back to the Garden of Eden, you know, inside us. And that often means pointing us back into the nature and source of our suffering, as the term states. We have to go within in order to transform that prima materia, that shadow material, through our awareness, in order that we can begin to uncover the light that's hidden inside that. And so human life and evolution is that journey. And the I Ching is a wonderful guidebook, a companion along the way. And the gene keys is a version of the I Ching in that sense. In some ways, it's more than that, because it brings it out into other systems, and it starts to assimilate other systems into it, including human design and the astrology and the tree of life and many other systems that you'll find riddled through the Gene Keys teachings. So it's a wonderful way to explore the I Ching. Of course, for me, it came and continues to come out of my deep core, and I'm not a sort of master of the I Ching in the sense, not the original I Ching. I did not base the Gene Keys on the original I Ching. It just came from within me. I didn't look at a hexagram, read it, think about it. I actually just explored it inside me without the book. So I didn't want the reference of someone else's thinking first. But the formulas with the yins and the yangs and the hexagrams, that very much guided me. And the meanings of those trigrams and those things also helped me understand and unlock some of the secrets in there. So there's an I Ching in every one of us, and the Gene Keys is designed as the synthesis so that all people can come and unlock the I Ching inside each of us. And then we no longer need the I Ching. We no longer need the Gene Keys because it's just alive in us. It is the mathematics of life, and it's changing revelation moment by moment that provides us with meaning, with purpose, with direction, with clarity, and with love. And that's the real purpose of the I Ching, to help us love more widely, love more unconditionally. That's what it's all about.